Good afternoon, and thank you for joining us on this Resurrection Sunday with the Helms.
Amen.
We would first like to thank you all for your wonderful comments, your positivity that you posted on the video last Palm Sunday. We thank you for the text messages and the phone calls. It was truly a blessing that God used us to do that great work on last week.
Amen.
But today we're exceptionally thankful to be with you once again. This by far has been the most memorable Resurrection Sunday.
Amen.
Just thinking back on all the ones that we've gone through.
Oh yeah, I can't remember any Resurrection Sunday being like this.
I know.
Wow.
However, we just really are thankful to our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ for giving us the opportunity to come and worship with you again on today.
Amen. Amen. And we certainly want to keep in mind all of those that are still dealing with the ill effects of the coronavirus. And not only that, you know, there's still a tremendous amount of people that are dealing with the effects from the virus itself and from the rippling, you know, job situation. 3 million people are probably out of work, if not more.
If not more.
And then those that have lost loved ones, our hearts go out to you deeply because it is, you're not able to do, you know, services and funerals like we normally would do. So some of those have had to do services via the telephone.
Yes.
And via the internet, just because they are not able to be with their loved ones at the time of loss. So certainly our prayers are with every pocket, but New York certainly needs a lot of prayers too.
Amen.
And we thank God for the healthcare workers and those that are in the medical field and the first responders,
absolutely,
those in grocery stores and retail outlets, and
all of our essential services.
All of the essential services. Amen. So we definitely want to get them lifted, keep those lifted up in our prayers, and let's just look to the Lord in prayer, if you don't mind. Father God, in the name of Jesus, we come to you on this Resurrection Sunday, thanking and praising your name because of all that you have done and continue to do. And Lord, we're just asking that you just have your way in the midst of our economy, in the midst of these trying times. We love you, we praise you, and we thank you in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Our Resurrection Sunday services with the Helms, if you will. I'm laughing because I'm just laughing. Just leave it that way. amen. God is good.
Yes.
God got it.
God our loves Sunday, a merry soul.
He loves a merry soul, and my soul is merry.
Amen. Amen.
Amen. Our Resurrection Sunday services start today in Matthew chapter 12 for a very, very brief time because we want to title this The Great Comeback. Amen.
Yes, amen.
And just to let you know how the great comeback affects us all. While Jesus was amongst the Pharisees, if you look in the book of Matthew chapter 12, it was very clear that Jesus was interrupting their lives at that time while he walked on the earth because of his claim to be the Son of the living God and that he claimed to be Lord even over the Sabbath.
Yes.
So they asked Jesus for a sign, and I love this because Jesus always had time to respond to silly questions.
Yes.
You know?
Yes. And not only that, Jesus would also ask questions that he already knew the answers to.
That's right.
To see where our hearts or
That's
their
right.
hearts were at
That's
the time.
Right. Amen. 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 So when they asked Jesus for this sign, I love Jesus' response. He said this, "A wicked and adulterous generation asked for a sign, but none will be given except for the sign of the prophet Jonah. For as Jonah was 3 days and three nights in the belly of a huge fish, so shall the Son of Man be 3 days and three nights in the heart of the earth." Now you could imagine how these Jewish leaders, how these Pharisees were feeling. They were infuriated with Jesus. The young people say they were jagged up. But it was probably extra long, so they were jagged up.
Oh my goodness.
Yeah, had the eyes and everything. They were all jacked up. And they were so mad that they continued with their plot to take Jesus's life. But remember, this was all a part of God's redemptive plan for us.
Amen.
Amen.
Thank you,
and
Lord.
So here's why I titled this message, The Great Comeback. But in order for me to really bring it back to reality here and for this message to make sense today, we got to take you to Matthew chapter 28, verses 1 through 7. I'm going to paraphrase a little bit. But after the Sabbath, at the dawn of the first day of the week, which we celebrate as Sunday, Mary Magdalene and the other Mary went to look at the tomb. There was a violent earthquake that had taken place. The stone was rolled back. Amen. Praise God. And then an angel was found sitting on the stone.
That's right.
And the guards, the Roman guards that were assigned to watch the body of Jesus, because remember, they were afraid that the disciples were going to come and take the body by night. The Roman guards were so petrified on what they saw that the scripture said they were just like dead men. They couldn't do anything.
My goodness.
And so what I love is that the angel who sat on that throne, he looked at those Marys, both Marys, and he said, I know that you're coming to look for Jesus, but he is not here.
He is not here.
He has risen as he said.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. And so you see, my friends, Jesus didn't just give us an example of Jonas's 3 days in the belly of the great fish in the Old Testament. His prophecy was about how he himself will be the propitiation for our sin, the final sacrifice, the ultimate sacrifice for mankind in order to get back to God. Yes. The Pharisees didn't like him.
No.
But they couldn't stop him.
No.
They couldn't stop him because the work that Jesus was already assigned to do, it was going to go forth regardless. Amen. So I want to ask a question. Do we even understand what that work did for us? Do we understand the implications that Jesus's work on the cross did for us? So we want to give you, both of us, want to give you 5 critical points to keep in mind because of Jesus's great comeback on this Resurrection Sunday. And the first point that I want you to keep in mind is that we should give God great praise.
Hallelujah.
For all that he's done for us out of his love, his grace, and his mercy that he so lovingly, not that we deserved it, don't get it twisted. We don't deserve anything. Well, we deserve something.
We would deserve death.
We deserve hell, but it's because of his grace and his mercy.
Yes.
And if you check out Isaiah 53, it'll let you know that even in our nastiness, and that is a word, even in our nastiness, Jesus was wounded for us.
Thank you,
He
Lord.
Was chastised for us. He was whipped and despised for us. He was stricken, beaten, and scourged for us, all because he loved us. Amen.
Amen. That's right, Patrick. And that is so good. And we're so grateful today that God truly loved us enough that he laid down his life.
Amen.
He went into that grave, and thank you, Jesus, he rose again. So not only do we want to give God great praise, we also want to give him unrestricted worship.
Amen.
Come on, somebody.
Amen.
We don't just want to praise him for what he's done for us. We also want to give him praise for who he is.
Amen.
We want to give him adoration.
Amen.
We want to give him the utmost worship.
Mm-hmm.
We know we're just not talking about somebody who walked the earth, saints. We are talking about the Lord of Lords, the King of Kings, one and only true and living God.
Amen.
Worship is intentionally expressing infinite worth of God. Come on now.
Oh man.
It goes on and on and on.
That's
because
right.
He is so worthy of our worship and our praise. You know what? That's what he created us to do.
That's right.
This is time for us to get in the mode of worship and of praise. Because you know what? Yeah. Once we make it to heaven, guess what we're gonna be doing all day?
Praising all the day
and
long.
Worshiping him all
for eternity.
Yes. So how?
Amen.
How can we give God our true intentional worship?
Well, we got to give it to him because of what he deserves in our undivided attention.
Amen.
We've got to give him praise in our undivided attention.
So how can we do that?
Well, every day when we wake up, we have breath in our lungs. It's another opportunity for us to study.
That's right.
For us to learn of his way.
That's right.
To learn about his amazing work, his amazing redemptive work on the cross for us. And then think about it this way. during these days, mm-hmm. our attention has, watch this, been arrested.
Amen.
Because of this pandemic.
Amen.
It has been. We are under house arrest, y'all.
We are under house arrest. And what Paul did when he was under house arrest?
Oh, man. Paul was a great warrior.
Come on now.
And he thought about studying the word of God and was finding ways to be better and better and better. And Paul even said while he was under arrest that I want to get closer to God,
yes.
So that I could understand the fellowship of His suffering.
Amen. Amen.
You know, I want to know about His resurrection, but I want to understand the fellowship of His
Amen.
Suffering.
Amen. And so while you're home mm-hmm. during this crisis time, mm-hmm. sing.
Yeah.
Pray.
Why not?
Read the word.
Amen.
Serve through giving.
Amen.
Through
Do so
giving.
Quietly.
Yes, you have so much time to meditate and think on all of God's love.
Amen.
That this is your time for you to give Him intentional worship.
That's
and
right.
Let's make sure that it's done in truth.
Amen.
And in spirit.
Amen. Amen. So, and because He has our undivided attention, you know, if you're straddling the fence, and we don't want to just make this seem like a negative message, but it's true. Sometimes, and I really feel like America has straddled that fence between what's right and what's wrong.
Come on.
And so when you're straddling the fence, now is a perfect time to get serious about Christ. You know why? Because He was deadly serious about us.
Amen.
So we got to stop letting the enemy sucker punch us and give God our undivided attention, because our undivided attention is what our amazing God deserves.
Amen. And that is so right. And not only give Him that undivided attention, but we also should praise and worship Him through our bodies.
Ooh,
our
man.
Bodies, folks, are a living sacrifice.
Not a dead one.
No, not a dead one. Holy, acceptable, righteous unto God.
Amen.
God don't want to live in any unclean places.
Not at all.
It's just like at home. Who wants to live in a dirty house?
That's right. Amen.
No one.
Amen.
So we want to make sure that we're taking care of our bodies and we have plenty enough time on our hands right now to be doing that. Eating right and
That's
exercising
right.
and keeping this temple worthy of God's presence.
Amen.
And that also means we need to do away with all this sexual immorality.
Yeah,
I'm
absolutely.
So sorry. But we don't want to talk about those subjects.
That's a scary subject.
That's a scary subject.
Yeah, 'cause we like that kind of stuff.
Exactly. So when we talk about our bodies, we're not only talking about what we eat or what we drink. And when we're doing that, we should be worshiping God as well. But we should take in account our sexual behavior and making sure that God is utmost pleased with that behavior.
Amen.
So keep that in mind. So flee away from sexual immorality and worship God with your body.
Amen.
That is what He created us for. That is what we should do. And we should do it with all life.
Amen.
Every area of our life.
That's right.
Not just one.
That's right. And remember, Cash, too, it's not only what we're taking in, you know, physically.
Mm-hmm.
Remember what goes in that eye gate.
Yes, come on.
And that ear gate.
All right,
those
somebody.
Are gates. Those are gateways. And when the gates open, things can come in.
Yes.
And so we have to make sure that, you know, especially during this time, it's a lot of Netflix, it's a lot of Disney Channel, it's a lot of whole lot of stuff that's being taken in.
Correct.
Some of that stuff God don't have a purpose for us to watch.
Amen.
And some of the music and the entertainment field that we listen to, some of that stuff is not meant for us to take in.
That's
because remember, you said it earlier, we are the temple of God.
That's
so it's not only how we want to take care of ourselves physically, but how we want to take care of ourselves spiritually too.
Amen.
On what we take in. So, and finally, my brothers and sisters, because of Jesus's great comeback, have an opportunity to get back.
Yes.
Come on now. Probably didn't see that coming. Because of His comeback, we have an opportunity to get back. Jesus told His disciples in John chapter 14 that I am going to prepare a place for you, that I'll come again, that when I come again, I'll receive you unto myself.
Amen.
That where I am,
yes,
you may be also.
Yes.
Saints, because of Jesus' great comeback out of that grave, amen. Because He stepped out of that grave, we have an opportunity now where when we confess with Him, confess in Him, believe in Him,
yes,
we now have an opportunity to have that rightful fellowship with Him. And watch this, when we pass away, we get a chance to go to heaven.
Amen.
And believe me, there's only two places that you're gonna that the soul is gonna end up. And heaven is one and hell is the other.
Amen.
You know, and so we get an opportunity to go be with him. He's already prepared the place for us. He doesn't have to work out the construction permit.
It's already
he doesn't have to go to the county and get a permit on that thing.
No.
It's already done. Mm-hmm. And so we have fellowship with Christ, and we have a chance to get back to God, whom we have fellowship with as well.
Mm-hmm.
Because of our disobedience, we once were ostracized from the kingdom of God. But now through Jesus Christ's blood and death, burial, and resurrection,
amen,
we have that opportunity to be in the fold, in the family. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. We're part of the clan.
We're part of the clan. That's
amen.
Right.
Amen. I thank you. And aren't you so glad about that?
I'm excited.
That is so huge, because we know that when things are finished here on this earth, that we have a place that we can go.
Yeah.
Where the streets are made paved with gold. Where mansions are already waiting for us to dwell. Where we can praise and worship our Heavenly Father all the day long. That's good news, folks. That's really good news.
That's good news. And especially because it's just fell in my spirit. It's not on our script, but I thank the Lord for not having a whole a script for us. We can do His thing.
We can just freely talk about
His
love.
When we get there, when we've done the labor for Him, building the kingdom, not just going to church. Going to church won't get you there.
No.
When we've done the labor for Him, we're pointing people to Christ. We're witnessing. We get to glory. And then He's got a crown of righteousness
set aside. Thank you,
and
Jesus.
I don't know about you, but I want to hear Him say, "Servant, well done.
Amen.
And I just thank God that the crown won't be for me to just wear around. That crown is going to be because of His glory that enabled me to do those things that He assigned me to do in this life and not waste it away.
Amen.
So I just had to throw that out there. We're just not going to heaven just to hang out.
No.
We're going to worship and be in the presence of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ and our Father God. That's amazing.
That's amazing. That is so amazing. So, saints, we would like to encourage you today during this time of crisis that you remember those 5 points that we just gave you today. Give God the praise.
Give God great praise.
Amen. Not just any old praise,
not just a
praise on the fly. Thank you, Lord. And act like you really done something for the day. But give God great praise with your whole self.
Amen.
And not only that, give Him unrestricted worship.
Unrestricted.
Fall on your face.
Yeah.
Fall down on the floor. Take off all the facade and really worship and praise God unrestricted.
Turn the radio off in the car on the way to work for those of you that are still working or going to meetings. Turn the radio off and get into that unrestricted praise and worship.
Amen. And give God your undivided attention.
Huh?
Yeah, your undivided attention. And just like we said, we have more time on our hands.
That's right.
Than ever before.
Amen.
So this is a time that we can spend with God quietly. We can spend time with God with our families, with our children. Some of you, ask your children, ask your grandchildren, do you know how to pray?
That's right.
Do you know what it means to pray?
With them.
Do you know what it means to read the word?
Right.
We need to take this time to give God our undivided attention and make sure that those who we love are doing the same.
That's right.
Amen, somebody.
Amen.
We also want to make sure that we are giving God glory through our bodies. Our bodies, saints, are a living sacrifice, holy,
acceptable,
righteous unto God.
That's right.
He dwells within us.
Mm-hmm.
What you're looking at when you look in the mirror, when we look in the mirror, is the temple.
That's right.
We are the temple, saints.
The temple.
It's not the church buildings.
Amen.
This is our time to give God all the glory,
all the
praise, through being a living sacrifice. Why? Because we have the opportunity to get back in fellowship with Him.
Amen. Amen.
Amen.
So we got to praise God for the great comeback. We thank the Lord Jesus for having that great comeback. Jesus said, I've got the right to lay down my life. And I got the right to take it back again.
That's right.
None of us have that.
That's right.
None of us can do that. But Jesus Christ, He did that. He laid down His life.
That's right.
And He took it back up again.
That's
I love that. So we got to continue praising Him, because when He stepped out of that grave, He had all power in both heaven and earth in His hands.
Amen.
So glory, hallelujah, for Jesus the Almighty King making that great comeback. He made the comeback as Redeemer.
Ooh.
He came in the flesh, just like you and I. If you pinched Jesus, he'd have said, ouch. You cut Jesus, he'd have bled. But the one thing that the old enemy didn't think about was that he was still Almighty God, packaged
thank
up.
You, Jesus.
He was just in flesh.
Yes.
He was packaged up. He didn't do things in a sinful way, but he was packaged in flesh just like you and I. And being the propitiation for our sins,
Hallelujah.
He was our replacement.
Yes.
Amen. And so Amen. We thank God for that. So we just giving God all the praise.
We just giving God all the praise.
Glory.
All
Amen.
The glory. Once
Amen.
Again, we are so excited.
Amen.
To share the love of Christ
Amen.
With you all
That's
through
right.
his word.
That's right.
Giving us an avenue
mm-hmm.
to come to you today.
Mm-hmm.
Some of you, most of us aren't having services at our churches.
I know.
But thank God for Jesus. The church is in our hearts.
Amen.
That we don't have to leave our homes.
No.
That we can worship and
Not
praise God right in the privacy of our home.
Right in the kitchen, y'all.
In the kitchen and with our families. So once again, we
Amen.
Thank you all for the positive support
Amen.
That you all have shown
mm-hmm.
us these past couple of weeks.
Amen.
We thank you, God, for all that you've done for us.
Amen.
And I believe you probably have had enough of us for today.
I think I'm done. I'm good.
You think you're good?
Yeah, I think
all
I'm
right.
good.
So I think at this time we'll go into a word of prayer. And then we'll let you all go back and enjoy your families and some of that good food that
I'm sure.
We don't smell no good food in our house today.
Nothing happening
right now. But maybe later on it'll get crunk as they say. We'll get crunk in here with some good smelling food.
It will.
Amen. So let's go with us in prayer right now. Father God, in the name of Jesus, we just thank you so much for this opportunity. We
mm-hmm.
thank you for your grace and your
thank
mercy.
You, Lord God.
We thank you, Lord, for having the opportunity to get together with the saints through
yes.
the internet, through YouTube, through Facebook, through TV,
Whatever.
Through all the avenues
Hallelujah.
That you have allowed for us to come together.
Yes.
Things of today are not like they used to be. They're not what we knew 3 weeks ago, a month ago. Things have changed, but Lord, what have not changed,
Hallelujah.
And that is you.
Yes.
You are the same today,
yes.
yesterday,
yes.
and forevermore, and we just thank you for
thank
that.
Thank you, Lord Jesus.
We ask you, Lord, to keep your hand over all your people, keep
yes.
a hedge of protection around all of those essential
oh, yes.
workers and
thank
their
you.
Families.
Yes,
we
Lord
ask
God.
You, Father God, to continue making a way out of no way,
yes.
continue to be in the will, in the middle of the will,
yes,
continue
Lord.
To allow your grace and your mercy to chase us down
oh, yes.
and to capture us and to
thank
keep
you.
Us under arrest.
Yes,
we
Lord
just
God.
Thank you, Lord
thank
God,
you,
for
Father.
All that you're doing.
Mm.
We thank you, Lord God, for never leaving or forsaking
Hallelujah.
Us. We thank you, Lord, that even in the midst of this crisis
you,
that
Jesus.
We can still call on you and
yes.
thank you, Jesus, that you will respond.
Yes.
So we asking you, Lord God, to continue to strengthen your people that we may stay deeper in your word,
deeper
that we may get
word.
More intimate and
yes.
more close to you.
Yes,
in
Lord.
This time of what the world is calling a crisis.
Yes, Lord,
Lord you know what you're doing.
Yes, sir.
And we are here to
thank
follow you.
You
every step of the way.
Thank you,
thank
Lord.
You for Minister Helm.
Yes,
thank
Lord.
You, Lord God,
thank
for his
her.
Heart and his spirit.
Yes,
thank
Lord.
You for the ministry that you have allowed us to do together
yes.
as a couple. And thank you for all those who are watching and who are staying in the midst
yes.
of you and your
Bless
word.
And keep them, God.
We just ask you to keep them in every area of their lives.
Yes, Lord
with
God.
These and many blessings in our Savior's name, we thank you, God, for rising.
Thank
we thank you, Lord God, for
Hallelujah.
Being in heaven
yes.
and preparing a place
yes.
for us
yes.
that we may be able to praise and worship you all
yes.
the day long.
Yes.
In Jesus'
name.
Amen.
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 We thank you. We love you. And
yes.
God bless and keep you until the next time. Take care.